Attorneys for both sides argued in court this morning about the legality of the governor's veto of funding for the House and the Senate. The crisis threatens to leave 500 staffers without pay starting as soon as next month. But late Friday, both sides agreed to 90 days of temporary funding. As Esme Murphy shows us, the case is now in the hands of the chief judge in Ramsey County.
Why should the courts get involved?
Judge John Guthman suggested a mediator several times in the hearing, but both sides said the bitter dispute was too far gone for that. The basic issue, does Governor Mark Dayton's line item veto power allow him to do what he did, eliminate $130 million in funding for the legislature? The legislator's attorney, Doug Kelly, argued no.
In 141 years, nobody else has, no other governor has done this. This is kind of the nuclear option.
But Sam Hansen, the governor's attorney, says the veto was legal. The judge then asked Hansen if the governor has the power to veto funding for the courts if he didn't like their rulings.
I think he can veto. That would be a very unsavory thing for a governor to do, and it is the extreme, but it's nothing near what we have present in this case.
Constitutional law professor David Schultz, who attended the hearing, thinks the governor is on shaky ground.
The governor has pretty broad authority to be able to use the line item veto, but you probably can't use it in situations like this where you use it to sort of essentially X out another branch of the government.
Speaker Kurt Dowd went further at a news conference.
The fact that the governor's attorney is willing to say that it would be unsavory if it's the judicial branch, but somehow it's okay if you do it to the legislative branch. No, it's just as unsavory and it's just as wrong.
Now, in a ruling late this afternoon, Judge Guthman gave his approval to the 90-day temporary funding proposal, which means everyone at the legislature, including those 500 staffers, will continue to get paid as this legal dispute plays out in court. The judge did not give any timeline, though, on a ruling on the larger issue of whether or not Governor Dayton's line item veto of the funding was in fact legal.
So if either side loses, could they appeal?
They can appeal, and both sides are indicating that they probably will. So in the end, this issue could get decided by the Minnesota Supreme Court.
All right. Okay. Thank you, Esme.